Elon Musk did a huge favor for Dogecoin and the entire market today. So, let's talk a bit more about it. Before we go any further, please keep in mind that we're giving away $500 to a random subscriber. All you have to do is like the video, subscribe, and leave a comment on your favorite crypto. Read our description for more info about it. Now, let's get started with today's video. Before we talk about Elon, let's talk about some bad news, and then we'll talk about how Elon came to the rescue. So, the IRS of the United States has proposed new tax changes to regulate crypto investments in the United States. Their most recent notification has outlined tax requirements for the marijuana sector. Basically, the federal agency wants to guarantee Bitcoin tax compliance among local firms that cultivate, distribute, and sell cannabis. And then there's the Senate's recent bipartisan infrastructure plan, which aims to collect $28 billion in cash by taxing crypto investments and transactions. Another thing was the nomination of Sol Amarova to head OCC. So, she's a law professor and is widely seen as anti-crypto and anti-big banks. If you don't know, the OCC oversees America's banking giants such as Goldman Sachs, JP Morgan, and Citigroup. And its head would also oversee aspects of the crypto industry. Basically, if she gets elected, it could be really bad for the market. Another thing was that Gary Gensler, head of the SEC, said that he believes that cryptocurrencies would not end well if it remains outside the regulatory realm. And then there was the former U.S. Treasury Secretary Larry Summers, who stated last week that Bitcoin will do better if it is regulated. Now, Gary also said that investors in the crypto market deserve the same kind of protection that many enjoy in the traditional market. And then he said that this crypto space is now certainly of a size that without those investor protections of banking, insurance and securities laws and market oversight, I do think somebody is going to get hurt. And after all this, Elon Musk came to crypto's rescue. So he said that the U.S. government should avoid attempting to control the cryptocurrency industry. Basically, he said that, "I don't think it's possible to kill crypto, but it is conceivable for governments to restrict its progress." And when someone asked him whether the government should regulate crypto, he said that government should do nothing. So we know how popular and influential Elon Musk really is. And so he's trying to protect cryptos like Doge from regulation because he knows that they will hamper its progress. And I'm just glad that he's looking out for Doge in these tough times. Now there's another thing that Elon did today. Before we look at it, let's talk about some more news that's creating FUD in the market. So, following the China crypto ban, exchanges in the region have suspended operations due to intense pressure from Chinese state banks. The country's crypto crackdowns triggered a surge in US sell-offs against the Chinese yuan. And then Huobi began to transfer cash after announcing that it will retire mainland China's active user accounts. Another news from China was that the biggest Ethereum mining pool is going to shut down. The mining pool stated that its decision was based on Chinese legal restrictions and that it will no longer accept new Chinese members beginning September 24. And then Alibaba also said that it will remove Bitcoin mining equipment from its sites. Basically, it will delist Bitcoin mining equipment offerings from its platforms and prevent further sales. And finally, China also blocked access to CoinGecko, CoinMarketCap, and TradingView via its internet firewall. Several tools confirm that these sites are all 100% blocked. And after all this, Elon came back to crypto's rescue again, while giving us some perspective about what's really going on. He said that, "It would appear the Chinese government doesn't love crypto. I suppose crypto is fundamentally aimed at reducing the power of centralized government, and they don't like that. And that's my guess." So, Elon is well aware of the fact that China is hammering down on cryptos, and he knows that people are afraid, so he's just trying to tell them to wait and see how it turns out. If you don't know, China has talked about banning cryptos almost 10 times in the last 10 years, and every single time, cryptos have come back to where they were. Now, there's another major Elon tweet from today. But before we talk about that, I'd just like to remind you that I'm not a financial advisor and this isn't financial advice. So you should definitely do proper research before investing anything into crypto. Now, let's try to get some perspective about how bad things really are in China. So, Stephen, a Shanghai-based crypto investor, said that, "These rules are not new to us, therefore we regard them as a buy signal." He also said that he purchased the Bitcoin dip using OTC counters. According to him, while the Chinese government has banned trade and mining of cryptos, it will not impose an absolute ban on owning them since such a move would be too difficult to implement. So basically, things aren't as bad as they seem. Now, let's look at another thing that's spreading FUD. According to a CryptoQuant article, Bitcoin whales have begun to sell their coins. It says here that the Bitcoin whale ratio has begun to rise over the 0.5 threshold. So, this whale ratio is a metric that estimates how many whales transmit their coins to exchanges, and it has risen several times in the last year. Now, each time it rose, it was followed by a drop in Bitcoin's price. But I think this is incomplete info. That article was trying to tell us that the whales aren't interested anymore. And now, take a look at his. So, a recent poll found that 62% of institutional investors are eager to invest in cryptocurrencies within the coming year. And the research includes involvement from institutional investors and wealth managers from the United States, United Kingdom, France, Germany, and the United Arab Emirates. And another thing we need to look at is according to an SEC filing, BlackRock has boosted the amount of Bitcoin futures contracts holdings during the first quarter of 2021. Also, BlackRock referenced Bitcoin in two prospectus filings with the SEC in January, implying that it would be researching the use of crypto derivatives. And also, it says here that BlackRock ETF owned 384 million in Bitcoin mining companies. Now, all of this matters because BlackRock is the world's largest asset manager. And we have to remember that the SEC filing by BlackRock came after the Bitcoin dip. So it just suggests that the big players are still bullish on crypto. But it doesn't end here. So, about the general crypto market, there's another report that tells us about the truth. In a new report, Chainalysis highlighted the rise of the digital economy in Central, Northern, and Western Europe. They said that crypto whales have been pouring funds into DeFi starting in July of last year. They also said that large institutional cryptocurrency transaction value grew from $1.4 billion in July 2020 to $46.3 billion in June 2021. The data shows that over the last 12 months, the majority of large institutional-sized transfers went to DeFi platforms. Given that, it's not surprising that the majority of those large institutional transfers were made in Ethereum and wrapped Ethereum. So this just tells us that the whales and institutions are really bullish on crypto and DeFi, which is totally different from the bearish article that we saw a while ago. Now, let's come back to Dogecoin for a minute. We know that it's been trading sideways. It was mentioned in only around 1,900 tweets, as per Cointrends data. And as per a report from CoinQuora, Doge has nearly oversold RSI of about 38 after losing 10% over the last 7 days. But still, I'm not too worried about it. So, according to Robert Kiyosaki, best-selling author of Rich Dad, Poor Dad, a huge market meltdown is on the way in October. And so he said that we need to hang on to our gold, silver, and Bitcoin positions and utilize cash to bargain hunt. And then he also discussed the possibilities of a government shutdown if the debt ceiling is not increased this week. Also, he's predicting that the real estate market will fall alongside the stock market. Basically, he sees China's Evergrande tragedy spreading to the United States. And because of all this, more and more people will jump onto Doge and other cryptos because they'll act as a good hedge against inflation. Another thing is that the house prices throughout the UK are probably going to rise by up to 3.5% each year between 2022 and 2024. While it also says here that the prices decreased by around £10,000 year-on-year this July, the point is that a lot of people will look at a different store of value after 2022. And this is pretty great for all cryptos. Coming back to Elon, he also tweeted something really interesting today. He stated that his goal is not to send himself to space, but to open space for humanity. And then Matt Wallace jumped in and reminded him about his promise to send Dogecoin to the moon. I'm just hoping that Elon listens to this message. As I've been saying, it looks like Elon is just waiting for the perfect opportunity to tweet about Doge. And he'll most probably do it when the devs announce that the major Doge fee upgrade is finally out. I think that because Elon dropped a couple of hints about it. First, he said that it was an important update for the future of Doge. And then he said that Doge needs this upgrade for AMC to accept it for movie tickets. Now there's another reason I'm not too worried about Doge. So, it says here that paying for Taco Bell with Dogecoin may soon be a reality. This is because one of the world's leading point-of-sale suppliers has teamed with BitPay. They're going to enable businesses in the U.S. to accept crypto payments. According to Stephen Pear, the CEO of BitPay, Verifone is by far the largest collaboration to date. Later this year, the newest Verifone terminals will start accepting payments for U.S. merchants from a range of cryptocurrency wallets and tokens. So, basically, the mass adoption for Dogecoin is on the way and all you have to do is hold onto your Doge. And this is it for today's video. Thanks for watching till the end. If you enjoyed it, please consider liking and sharing it with your friends. Also, please subscribe to the channel and turn on post notifications for daily videos on Dogecoin and cryptocurrency. If you have any questions or suggestions, please leave them in the comments section below. Goodbye. Take care.